The following are the types of unemployment. Hope you can see the slide. Types of unemployment. Cyclical unemployment, seasonal unemployment, frictional unemployment, educated unemployment, technical unemployment, structural unemployment, and disguised unemployment. So these are some of the types of unemployment. In 2 marks, they might ask you to list down the types of unemployment. If they ask, list down the type of unemployment, you just need to number it and write the types 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. You number it and write all the 7 types of unemployment if it is a 2 marks question. If it is a 3 marks question, they might ask you separately, write about cyclical unemployment or write a note on technical unemployment. What do you mean by disguised unemployment? So in 3 marks question, they might ask any one of these 7 types. If it is a 5 mark question, they'll ask you to write about the types of unemployment, maybe in 2 pages. If they ask you to write, then you have to write all the 7. Sometimes specifically they will ask, explain any 4 types of unemployment. In that case, you can select any 4 and write. Okay, if not, you have to write all the 7 types of unemployment if asked in as a 5 marks question. Now let us see what the types of unemployment. First one, cyclical unemployment. What do you mean by cyclical unemployment? This unemployment exists during the downturn phase of trade cycle in the economy. Downturn phase of trade. Okay, let me move on to the next slide. Cyclical unemployment. This happens during the downturn phase of trade cycle. What do you mean by downturn? You will be studying about the trade cycle in the 4th chapter. So during a trade cycle, there are different stages. Recession, depression, boom, recovery are some of the stages of the trade cycle. Here, what do you mean by downturn? That means it is coming down. The trade cycle is coming down. So in a business cycle, during the period of recession and depression, this is the meaning of a trade cycle taking a downturn. Okay, the trade cycle is coming down. So recession and depression is a phase when the trade cycle falls down. Recession, from the word itself, you can understand depression. Okay, there is a fall in the economy. That stage only is called as recession and depression. What happens in a business cycle? During the business cycle, trade cycle, all are the same. In a business cycle, during the period of recession and depression, income and output fall, leading to widespread unemployment. For example, you take the present scenario. Okay, from March, the government has been announcing lockdown. So many factories are being shut. Okay, people are being asked to stay at home. So what happens to the production? The production or the output has fallen. The consumption has reduced. People are not going out. All the shops and showrooms are closed. So there is less demand. So the output has fallen. What happens when the factories are shut for a long time? The employer says, see, I'm not able to provide job for you. 3 months already I've given you salary. 4th month I'm not going to give you salary. I will give you half salary, 50%, or I will give you 25%. So there is a depression in the income. Okay, so the income has reduced. So the purchasing power, okay, the people are not spending more. So there is widespread unemployment. Are you able to understand? It is caused by deficiency of effective demand. There is no demand in the society. When we all were coming to school, you would have bought books, bags, pencils. Okay, you would have taken an auto or a bus. Now, what has happened to your demand? The demand, there is a deficiency in the demand. People are not spending more. because all of us are at home. We are not doing shopping any longer. We are all indoors. So there is a deficiency of effective demand. When the demand falls, the production or the output also falls. Naturally, there will be a depression in the income. So many people will lose their job during this time. Such an unemployment is called as cyclical unemployment. Okay. Did you all understand? Next one is called as seasonal unemployment. This unemployment happens only during certain seasons. Unemployment occurs during certain seasons of the year. It is not throughout the year, all the 12 months. Some people will be working for 3 months and the remaining 9 months they'll be staying at home. Some people will work for certain seasons, maybe 6 months. For example, take umbrella business. Suppose if a person is selling umbrella, when will his business boom? During the rainy season or during the summer, peak summer, people will use umbrella. What about the other seasons? He cannot sell umbrellas. So there will be unemployment during such seasons. For example, you take sugar cane. In agriculture and agro-based industries like sugar, production activities are carried out only in some season. When do you get sugar cane? During Pongal time. Okay, so only during that time, sugar cane factories will be functioning because they get sugar cane in plenty and immediately they do the crushing and we get the sugar. What happens in other seasons when there is no sugar cane? The factory will be shut. So people will be losing their job. Such an unemployment is called a seasonal unemployment. Unemployment occurs during certain seasons of the year. In agriculture and agro-based industries like sugar. What do you mean by agro-based industries? Industries which are dependent on agriculture for their raw materials are called as agro-based industries. For example, if you take sugar. Sugar industry is an agro-based industries because the raw material for a sugar industry is sugarcane. Production activities are carried out only in some seasons. Therefore, people may remain unemployed during the off season when there is no sugarcane cultivation. It is called as off season. People will not have any job. Seasonal unemployment happens from demand side also. This is from the supply side. What about demand side? When do we eat ice cream? Only when it is very hot, during summer. So what happens during summer? There is a demand for ice cream. So ice cream industries will flourish during summer. What about rainy season and winter? People will not buy ice creams. So there will be unemployment in the ice cream industry during winter season when it is very cold. Similarly, holiday resorts. When do we visit resorts? It is given here during the holidays. So during May or January or December, okay, the holiday industries will, the resorts, the holiday resorts industries will flourish. People will go more to resorts. Tourism will flourish during that season. In calamities or COVID crisis, all the tourist spots are closed, hotels are closed, hotel industries, all the resorts are closed now. So people will be losing their job. This is called as seasonal unemployment. Next one, frictional unemployment. It is also called as temporary unemployment. It is not permanent, it is temporary. Frictional unemployment arises due to imbalance between supply of labor and demand for labor. What do you mean by supply? Okay, the number of people who are willing to work is called as supply. What do you mean by demand for labor? All the people will not be given jobs. Only a certain number of people will be asked to come for a job. That is only called as demand for labor. Sometimes there is an imbalance. What do you mean by imbalance? The supply of labor is more. There are 100 teachers to work in a school, but there is a demand for only one teacher. So there is an imbalance. 100 teachers are there willing to work. The supply is 100, whereas the demand for the teacher is only one. So what happens? There is an imbalance. Hope you understand it, girls. There is an imbalance. 100 teachers are coming for a job, but there is vacancy only one for one person. There is demand only for one person. So the others will not get a job. This type of unemployment is called as frictional unemployment. Did you understand?